We are back. Episode 4 of Double Up. And this one right here is a goodie. For those that don't know what Double Up is where you take two characters that were in two different promotions in wrestling. You put them together, run down their pros and cons, and then we decide, me, King HP, Archie Carter, which character was better. And we hang their jersey up in the Raptors. And today, none other than the Giant versus Big Show. That's what we're doing today. Shout out to the legend, Paul White. That is the discussion we're having. If you have not subscribed to the Attitude Era podcast, make sure you do so now. Hit the notification so you can get notified when we are dropping all these exclusives and when we go live. Like, share, and comment on this video right here. And like I said, we will take a minute between each pro. We all get a turn, goes around. 1 minute on the con, then we move on, do the same with the next character, and then we have the discussion and come to the vote on which character was better.
And for those who don't know, Danny, let them know who in the Raptors right now.
Okay, so right now, Leah, let's run that for y'all. So episode one is Scott Hall versus Razor Ramon, and after deliberation, we are putting Razor Ramon's jersey in the Raptors. So Razor Ramon to us was the better character than Scott Hall. Rest in peace to the legend. Episode two, Kevin Nash versus Diesel. After deliberation, we are putting Kevin Nash's jersey in the Raptors. And episode three, which might happen again, but for now it is our first and only triple up. We had the 1-2-3 Kid versus Six versus X-Pac. And after deliberation, X-Pac's jersey got hung in the Raptors. So Razor Ramon, Kevin Nash, X-Pac are in a Double Up Hall of Fame right now. And now we will see.
Today, either Big Show or the Giant.
Let's get started, fellas. We'll run the same order. I'm cool with it. I'm ready to go.
Let's go.
Ready to go?
Yep.
Let me get the clock and go.
The Giant had a big debut in the WCW. His debut match was against the legendary Hulk Hogan, and he won due to disqualification with Jimmy Hart, and he had that gold around, you know what I mean, his waist, even though it was only for a day, you know what I mean, that's a hell of a debut. So that was his debut. He teamed up with Ric Flair, won the WCW title versus Ric Flair before, then won the tag titles on multiple occasions with Scott Hall, I believe with Sting, Lex Luger. He joined the NWO several times. He had a great feud with Kevin Nash. That was like the two big men going at it. I remember being a kid, like, wow, we get the Giant versus Kevin Nash. So that was amazing, you know what I mean? He had the WCW title around him, and he had some tag belts also. So the Giant had a good reign. And he was also kayfabe Andre the Giant's son. So, you know what I mean? That was also a good, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah. He had it. You got me, HP?
Absolutely. Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
The Giant. You mentioned the Giant. You mentioned Hogan. You mentioned Flair. You mentioned Sting. You mentioned Macho Man. He was in the ring with some legends because he could go. I remember watching a documentary about the Giant. He said they actually asked him to change his moveset because of the things he was doing. He had top rope splashes. He was doing drop kicks from the top rope. His in-ring work ability was crazy, and they asked him to actually stop because they didn't want that to be what the character was. But in the ring, he could go. He looked good. He wrestled. And one of the highlights for me in WCW, he was part of the Dungeon of Doom with Kevin Sullivan and the rest of that crew. And I really liked that. For some reason, I was drawn to that as a kid. So Giant in WCW, for me, big man that can move. Plus, he a South Carolina boy. And shout out to Charlotte. So WCW Giant, great matches, just overall good guy. HP, it's on you.
All right.
Let's go.
All right, we're talking about the Giant. We're talking about the one by the commentary crew as the son of Andre the Giant, right? So that already put him in a crazy light because Andre the Giant had a 10-year undefeated streak and was the guy in wrestling prior to Hogan. So right there, that cast the shadow, or not a shadow, but a light. His first match, as pointed out by DNA, was a world title match where he was walked out by Kevin Sullivan, coincidentally. So, you know, he was coming out with big shoes because the Dungeon of Doom and a world title match as his first opportunity. His second title run, he beats Ric Flair. So that's as big as big gets, because really you beat the top two guys of the company in about a 1 year span, because he beats Hogan at Halloween Havoc. He beats Flair at Nitro in 96. And on top of that, he had other title runs, tag team titles as well within WCW. So he really could do no wrong. And he was always the guy who had great matches with all bigs that WCW had.
There we go. Mm.
Solid. Shout out to the Giant, man. Andre the Giant's son, man. I really believed that as a kid. That's why I keep referencing that back, because that was just like, that was good storytelling at the
time.
They
worked you, man. You got work, dude.
Yeah, I believe you. Let's jump into the cons whenever you're ready, Archie.
And go.
Short title runs. All these title runs that he had when he actually had the belt, they weren't anything worth talking about. Yeah, they put the belt on him, but it was kind of like a thing to do, and then it was stripped from him to where it was never no real reign, where it was an impact made with the belt. That is a con for me. Also, the con for me was just like, he was like an NWO flunky. Like, obviously, that is not to his fault, but that is to the fault of Eric Bischoff. It's like they'll write him in NWO 1 week, the next week they're spray painting on him and violating him. So it was kind of like that takes away from the mystique of this 7'1" character, where he's just expendable to, you know what I mean, the biggest faction, either have him be a part of it to where he's the muscle, or you know what I mean, have him be a rival that you know what I mean, they're gonna take at least 7 members to beat up, not just 1 week he's in, next week he's out. Like the flunky thing just really like messed it up for me. That was a big con. And then last but not least, just no real storyline outside of just being a connection to the NWO. It was nothing really set for the Giant.
All right.
Good night.
Ready, HP?
Absolutely. And go.
For a big man, he had a short ceiling. Again, DNA said it. He was the scapegoat. He was the butt of the jokes. He was the punchline. When they needed a punchline or they needed somebody to go to, it was him, unfortunately. In the title range, you when you have a champion who you want to get it and you want to keep it, unfortunately, the range, like HP said, it was only one of them was 1 day. Like, that doesn't really do much for your legacy. I mean, it's a stat, but how much of a stat is it if it doesn't do anything for you and elevate the company and elevate you as a champion? So even with what I mentioned, his pros, his in-ring work was good, but they actually told him, slow it down. So I don't know what the ceiling could have been, but I do know there was a ceiling for him. For some reason, somebody in the back was like, we can't let this guy be the guy, when he easily could have been the guy.
Boom.
Good night.
HP, go.
All right, so one thing I did not like was that they used him as the son of Andre the Giant, because that's a lot. I believed it too, did they? So you ain't the only one in that boat. However, when they go away from that storyline, it's like, oh, yeah, I thought he was the son. Like, why lie about something like that? If you keep the lie, keep it. If you're not going to do it or go away from it, don't do it. So his debut was weird, because it happened at Halloween Havoc. Yes, he wrestles Hogan. I'm not talking about the match. I'm talking about the monster truck rally that they had, Hogan versus the Giant with monster trucks. Like, what are we doing here? And then they use Michael Buffer, right, for the ring announcer for this event. Michael Buffer is world-class announcing, and they made Michael Buffer mess up at Halloween Havoc 29-95. He calls out the Giant, reads all his stuff out, boom, and guess who comes walking out? Hogan. And he's like, whoa, wait, oh, there's a change. So, no, you can't mess up Michael Buffer, man.
Can't mess up Michael Buffer. You didn't think the Hulk Hogan monster truck with the arms was fire when he was a kid?
I hated it.
Oh.
And he was on the edge. They're like, oh, he's not going to come out tonight. Hogan was in some weird.
He was a different type of kid, man.
So that was the pros and that was the cons of the Giant. So DNA, let's get into the pros and cons of
well, it's the big show. It's a big
and show. Go.
The Big Show, the Big Show's debut was at the St. Valentine's Day Massacre in 1999, which was an impactful debut. He popped up from the ring, 7'2", chokeslammed Stone Cold through the cage, which actually helped Stone Cold win and get his shot back to WrestleMania to go against The Rock. But big impact, big, big debut. He took it serious. He felt like this was an important character. He has a ballroom match with Mankind at WrestleMania. That was a great match. Him and Mankind did the faction with the Union, teamed up with The Undertaker, won some belts. Also managed to be the official winner of Royal Rumble in 2000, which led him to be in the main event of WrestleMania 2000, which was a heavy win. He also won the championship title by beating Triple H and The Rock. How could you not give credit for that? And he was also the first person to pin Brock Lesnar.
Hey, a strong argument. You ready?
Off to win. Yeah. Ready?
Yep.
Set. Go.
The Big Show. We saw him win gold in WWE, WWF. Got some titles on him. But like DNA said, the impact he had in WWE, WWF was something he could have had in WCW because he elevated people in the ring. DNA said it. Stone Cold won the match because of the interference. Other things were elevated because when you have this big attraction that you see, he should elevate things. He wasn't used that way in WCW. Like I said, the ceiling wasn't really there in the WWE, WWF. And he has some of the best highlights ever with some of the strength spots he did because they let the big man be the big man. And we let the big man be the big man, it makes everything bigger and larger. And the Big Show character was like a lovable giant, man. But in the ring, again, that was my favorite part of everything about him. He can really wrestle and go, and he elevated, and the impact was what it should have been in this company that it wasn't in the other. HP?
All right.
Let's go.
All right, so my man's a two-time WWE champion, triple threat match with The Rock. He also has a Survivor Series win over Brock Lesnar. He's also a two-time world heavyweight champion, which is that big gold belt over Brock Lesnar and Mark Henry. He's also the ECW champion, where he beats Rob Van Dam. So he has a triple crown of world titles from three different companies, even though after 2001, you know what I'm saying, it was bought by... Anyway, we're moving on. Keeping it with them titles. Intercontinental title. He beats who? The American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes at WrestleMania 28. He wasn't going by American Nightmare then. But then you got the U.S. title. He beats Eddie Guerrero, right? So he's got a who's who. Five-time World Tag Team Champion. Three-time WWE Tag Team Champion. First, the inaugural Andre the Giant Battle Royal winner. You know what I'm saying? He is the guy. And secondly, when you talk about his in-ring work, when Floyd Mayweather came to the WWE, who do they trust him to fight at WrestleMania? The Big Show.
Solid. Big Show said Floyd Mayweather was supposed to hit him, I think, like one or two times. He said he hit me like five times and broke my nose.
He broke his nose. And that was...
And Floyd, he was wrong for them shorts. He was wrong for them shorts.
He broke my man's nose.
Broke it. All right, DNA... Big Show cons, ready?
Yeah.
Go.
Big Show cons. Big Show with his character in WWE, even though he had a lot more, I would say, success than the Giant character, it still fell short to where he could go because his ceiling became short due to him not being in good shape. That was one of the main issues. They sent him down to OVO multiple times. Oh, I think I said it wrong. I said OVO, Drake's label. I forgot what it is, but y'all can correct me. They sent him to the other promotion multiple times, and he just kept becoming a mid-carder instead of being at the top of the food chain because of him not wanting to get in good shape. Also, the feud with Big Boss Man with the casket being dragged, I wasn't a fan of them bringing his dad passing in real life onto the screen. It was a terrible angle, terrible way it was executed. Just didn't like it. It was very, very bad taste. Nobody really liked it. Also, all his champion runs were short as well. Even with Daniel Bryan, like he had a 45-second championship run. And it's like when you're that big with that physique, you know what I mean? You just can't have all these short runs where it looks like you're weak. So That's my cons.
All right. That's that. I'm ready.
Ready and go.
The strength spots, we love. The slap the chest, we love. But outside of that, a lot of stuff he did in WWF was just goofy. The sumo match, goofy. The casket thing, goofy. Again, somehow,
goofy.
He was the scapegoat in WCW. He was the punchline, and he became the punchline to a lot of stories in WWF. Not saying his in-ring work wasn't good, but why are we laughing and making the biggest man in the room the joke? Again, I think it's pop politics as usual. Things in the back give people ceilings, and the ceiling was big. Then I think they put him in a box again, and he ended up being the comedic, funny. That's the thing. He was like I say, a lovable giant, but they didn't make him seem like a real big threat all the time. So that was the biggest thing of the cons for me, was that he ended up being, again, like the punchline to the jokes. And it just was goofy. HP?
Yeah, I probably won't even need the minute, man.
We're going to give it to you anyway. Go.
Okay. So it's funny you bring up the casket and the father passing angle. I hated the John Cena and the rap angle. I really like, again, and you just talked about this, Archie. You're the biggest guy in the room. You're the threat. You're the one that people should be shook from. When Floyd broke his nose, he was literally running out that arena because, you know, things happen. And that's the biggest flaw. Also, those championship runs are very short. When you start having those runs where everyone can just beat you, Cody Rhodes beat you for Intercontinental title before Cody Rhodes ever takes off. Some of those titles losses, the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal did nothing for him. It was just like a dud. Like, it hasn't done anything. Like, you win King of the Ring, you get a world title shot. Some people were duds, but a lot of them went on to do bigger and better things. It catapulted him. And that did not. It almost did the opposite. You were expected to win. You've been in multiple now. They had him go against Shaq. No match. And it just wasn't good.
Goofy.
There y'all have it, man. The pros and the cons of, well, it's the Big Show.
And
Big Bad Show.
Giant. So, you know what time it is? It's time to take the vote and see who Jersey getting hanged up. DNA, it's on you.
What's interesting about these two characters is I feel like they have the same, most out of all three of the other characters we did, none of them had the same similarities. I feel like everything we liked about the Giant, we liked about the Big Show. Everything we didn't like about the Giant, we didn't like about the Big Show. It's kind of like, even though it was different writers in two different promotions, they utilized them the same way, in a good way and a bad way, on both companies. So what it really boils down to is, where was the more success at for Paul White? And it was in the WWE. So I'm going with Big Show. It was a longer run. It was more of an impact. I believe if we go to what got him in the Hall of Fame, he is in the Hall of Fame for the Big Show, not the Giant character. The Giant character can be forgotten about. The Big Show character cannot, with the flaws with it. It had a lot of great moments with it. He is one of the only Triple Crown champions in the WWE. He won the ECW title. He won the Intercontinental title. He won the World Heavyweight title. He won the Tag Team title. He is decorated. He's been in matches with the best of them: Stone Cold, The Rock, Triple H, Undertaker, Kane, John Cena, Miz, Chris Jericho, Kurt Angle, Brock Lesnar. The list goes on. Still the first man to pin Brock Lesnar. The list could go on with Hulk Hogan. The list could go on with the Big Show character. So for me, I'm putting the Big Show in the Double Up Hall of Fame. I'm lifting this person.
For me, it's pretty much the same, man. Which of these characters do I have the best memories of? Again, you know, DNA mentioned it. He got typecast. That's what they just saw him coming strong, coming hot. Eventually, he's the butt of the jokes, and they laughing at him, man. Again, some of his own decisions may have played into that. We don't know, but the help thing, the politics, is just a lot. And again, this is one of the tightest races we probably have, because both characters had the same pros and the same cons. But the Big Show run, it was longer. It was fun. And for me, I have some of the best memories of and with the Big Show. So I'm going to throw my vote for the Big Show to get his jersey raised in the Double Up Raptors. HP, is you going to sweep it or you might be a Giant guy because you didn't like the Hulk Hogan monster truck. And what kid didn't like that? So
I hated it. I absolutely hated it. And the Giant made some huge, first match, we don't know you from a can of paint. And it's a world title run, even though it was very, very short. Then that's again the problem with the Big Show. I feel like he was, I don't want to say he was okay with being the way he was, but I wish he would have just put his foot down, or they would have had a better writing form or whatever it was in the back to make him at least get a 2-3 year run, 4 year run maybe, where you're just, even like they did this for the Undertaker, so almost his whole career. So I know it could be done. You know, Undertaker was never booked to just start losing and being and getting beat up and stuff like that. So I really feel bad because the Big Show, just pure size, it writes itself, he did have some interesting matches. But to be honest, too, he does have some amazing highlights because at the end of the day, the Floyd Mayweather, they're able to secure that. They put him in there with a safe wrestler, great storyline, the big versus the baddest. It was like the biggest versus the bad, something like that. I have to go with Big Show, man. And listen, he's got an iconic song that I hate. You hear people say it, like we even start, well, it just rings out. Everybody knows.
You're just saying his character wasn't really protected.
It wasn't protected.
So what jersey are you lifting up, man?
I gotta lift up the Big Show's jersey, man. I gotta put in the rap.
Yo, man.
3-0.
Look, tried to fight him. You know what I mean? I wanna wear what we doing, man. At the end of the day, unanimous decision. Big Show's jersey is getting lifted in a Double Up Hall of Fame. Shout out to the legend Paul White. We seen him I seen him at AEW a couple last year, actually. So he's still up and running. He's moving, commentating a little ring action every once in a while. Stay tuned, y'all, for the fifth episode of this Double Up series. And this is going to be a special one when I tell you. And it's going to be a tough, tough decision. The next two, they're going to shock y'all when y'all see where they are. So make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, share it out, hit the notification button so y'all can get all of the Double Ups as soon as they go live and all of the other content that we are dropping on the Attitude Era podcast. Big shout out to y'all. Big shout out to HP, Archie Carter. We out there. Good night.